know I've been on a long break. This is because I had a lot of shoots.
On today's video, I am going to be sharing with us tips on how to get rid of busyness and get a grasp on your productivity.
So let's jump right into it, yeah?
Now, when I'm talking about laziness, I'm not referring to like occasional lazy days. Lazy days are actually very important. Like, see, nobody needs to tell you when you need to chill. But when you start to have more lazy days than not, then that's where there's a problem. I believe that everybody in the world is creative. I believe that everybody can create something. So laziness is one of the things that hinder us from discovering our genius, reaching your potential, maximizing your...
Thank you.
Okay, so I got the idea to do this video when I had some time yesterday to take a walk down memory lane, and I saw how far I've come since last year when I started putting a lot of time and work, basically effort, into my career as an actor. Guys, I've gone far, bagbeo, not trying me. Anyways, and I realized some little steps that I took, which I saw as insignificant then, have proven very useful for me. Legit, if anybody that knows me, that's watching me, knows that I'm a very lazy person. Actually, all my friends have been even asking me that, how am I doing it? Like, putting so much effort, how did I do it, blah, blah, blah. So, this video is for you guys. During the lockdown, there was a lot of time. Like, there was a lot of time. So, what I spent my whole lockdown doing was pondering on one single question for hours and hours. I would sleep off, reading my Bible, writing. So I kept on asking myself, why am I stuck? And guys, I got the answer. When I finally got the answer, it was another question. Okay, the answer was, tell me, Victoria, actually, you're lazy. It's like, oh, wow, what can I do about this? I got the answer, but it's not helpful. I can't just be going and waving, oh, I'm lazy, in people's faces, and this will get me to where I want to be. So I thought, how can I stop laziness? I googled, I read a lot of articles, did everything. Now, the answer to this question can never be as cut and dry as you expect. Never. Because I think there are like levels to laziness. There might be somebody that's lazier than I am, somebody that's less lazy than I am. Oh, there are levels to it. So there's no specific way to stopping laziness. I mean, and I don't think you ever stop being lazy. You just learn how to work. I mean, for me, I learned how to work in a way that's comfortable for me. I'll take a spoon of my beautiful. God damn it. It's so awesome. Mm-hmm. I swear.
Like 100%.
Even highly productive people find it difficult to get things done sometimes.
You put the sauce.
No.
Yeah, I tried the sauce, man.
Gosh, even just the rice is awesome. So let's just jump right into it. I need to be fast because for lazy people don't have time to listen to too much talk. By the way, I want to show you guys this beautiful restaurant where I'm at, more than I want to talk about laziness. The first thing I did was I picked out a very, very simple task for myself. I picked out a simple task. I chose a specific time period and a goal that I wanted to achieve in that specific time period. Guess what the task was? I decided to write down 3 quotes from 3 different people that inspire me every day. I remembered yesterday's quotes the next day when I'm about to write the 3 quotes for that day. This is my diary-ish. Ah, you can't see it. But I'm just going to move it a little bit closer. Can you see? So if you can see here, there's 4th of April, blah blah blah. I got April from January, by the way. So there's tons and tons of quotes in this book. If you need me to send this to you, say hey in the comments. I did take the quotes from like online, like known quotes. I watch these people's videos. So every day I have to do. So my own was kind of extra because I was under pressure. I put myself under pressure because I wanted to change very fast. So you can do a little bit more. I mean, a little less. I did this for 3 months, non-stop. I never missed a single day. Let me tell you, if you're a lazy person, I kid you not. All those things that they'll be saying, oh, don't take it easy on yourself, don't try too hard. When you're starting out, like when you're looking to change things and like stop being lazy, you need to start hard. Legit. For me, I don't know what. That's why I put a lot of pain on myself. I had to start hard. Like, I did a lot of. While I was, these 3 things I mentioned, just the only first thing I did. If you can't start hard,
get yourself an accountability partner. Or if you want to work alone, then it means you have to be extra hard on yourself to make sure that you get results.
This one's very, very important. Celebrate your slightest wins. Because of how much I wanted to change and do better, I didn't have time to celebrate anything. Like, I just wanted to see changes. Meanwhile, there were little changes already that I didn't notice. Why? I'm looking back to where I came from. Last year, this time last year, I have grown. And this is me clapping for myself. So, celebrate your slightest wins. Celebrate it. It will ginger you to continue and do better. Make sure whatever you're doing, whatever that task is, the little task that you do, make sure you enjoy doing it. Make sure it's something fun. See what I did now? I picked 3 people that I really like. So when I'm watching anything that has either of them in it, I am enjoying it. And then I remember to do the task I'm supposed to do because of that. So this is just, I don't know, but this is not like practical, because there's no practical answer to how to stop being lazy. These are just like things you can do to effect change in your personality and your habits. Because Napoleon Hill said in one of his books that people are made up of their habits, like the things that you do constantly. I'm not sure that's exactly how he said it, but that's what I got, Sha. Like, the things that you do constantly define your personality. So you can change, forget it, you can change your personality, you can change who you want, you can change from who you are today to who you want to be tomorrow. And on that note, guys, I end this whole motivational speaker trash.
Okay, so that's all. Thank you guys for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please subscribe, like, and drop a comment. So I'm going to show you guys around.
Okay guys, so this was at Orchid Thai Gardens restaurant in Ikeja, JRA. Their food is amazing and affordable-ish. So like their dishes range from like about 4,000 naira and above, like that. So we had this nice fried rice. With, I've forgotten the name, chai, but it made sense. And their customer service, oh my gosh, they were so pleasant, very pleasant. The ambience is also very lovely. There are a lot of cool photo spots. I think this is a nice place for bridal showers, birthday parties, dates, and all of that. I love this place. I would give it 10 over 10. You should go there if you want. Bye. Don't forget to subscribe.